Hello, coffee drinkers. Today was kind of my very feeble, as it turns out, attempt to have a day off and to take it easy and really not do that much. Of course, that is exactly the opposite of what happened, but at least that was in my mind. That was at least relaxation and taking time off and not doing anything crazy was definitely in the back of my mind, if not in the forefront. But what did end up happening is that today's vlog, I have two things for you. Very, very simple. One is a thing I'm going to show you on the bass. The other is a thing I'm going to show you from a few nights ago with Bob's band at a baked potato with Teddy and Dave and Ty. We'll get to that in a little bit. But this thing you probably heard right at the start of the vlog. I was just working on some vocabulary things today and came up with this phrase. It's kind of reminiscent of a bunch of different things. Like when I think back and look back on my history of influences and things I've transcribed and things I've listened to so much, it's a pattern-based thing. It could be attributed to maybe John Coltrane or perhaps a more refined version of that, like a Michael Brecker thing. But whatever it is, it was great today to populate my practice routine with it a little bit from a technical standpoint and to move around the instrument and to cover a lot of the fingerboard with one simple idea. And it's kind of two key centers, so A flat and C. With a little bit of chromaticism in there. So up the A flat major scale and back down again. And then here comes the chromaticism, just one chromatic note out of the scale of A flat, which is A natural. So everything else is in A flat so far, but just that one note, A natural, is not in the scale. And I'm purposely not putting sheet music up or really going that deep into exactly what the notes are, because if you want to learn the lick, I think I'm playing it slow enough, I'm playing it enough times and explaining it basically enough that you should be able to get it pretty quickly, and that will help your ear, and that will definitely be less kind of spoon-fed. Like every time I ever, and I really did this very, very rarely, but every time I looked at an idea in a book or went to somebody else's transcription, I never remembered it. I never remembered the idea. It went in one ear, I played it for a little while, and clunk, it fell out on the floor at the other side, and I would never remember. I'd never retain that information. So super important to really work on your own transcription of things when you're transcribing stuff, when you're trying to assimilate information and learn vocabulary. And I will tell you that the thing moves down, at least I'm using it moving down in whole steps. So I'm starting out in A flat, I've got our two key centers. So A flat, C, and then G flat to B flat, and so on and so forth, going down in whole steps. And the success and the fluidity with which I play this idea, I think, stems from really concentrating, honing in on the fingering and the articulation and how I'm actually playing it with both the left and the right hand, and where I'm hammering on, where I'm actually plucking the notes. Like if you take a look at what my right hand and left hand are doing there. So the first one is being hammered. In a higher tempo, maybe there would be one more pull in there. There. And a couple of more hammers at the top, maybe at a higher tempo. I haven't really wound it up today. Like I said, I was trying to take a day off, unsuccessfully, but I was really trying to take a day off. I did take a day off from the gym, I did take a day off from tennis, and I did sit here and work on the book a little while, and of course I practiced for a few hours, so a half day off, I would say. But I got this idea out of today. That was awesome. You know, playing that over a pedal, so. once I have the idea, trying to fit that in and kind of move it around the instrument. And of course, it sounds like a pattern there. It just sounds like a repetitive, pretty unmusical idea when you play it over and over and over again. But that is how I experiment with it. I go trial and error and move it all around the instrument as much as possible. Then I start to find the things that I like about it, the things I dislike about it, gravitate more towards the things I like, obviously, and then go and develop them further. That's the process. And that is, for today anyway, a little sneak peek inside what I guess what a day off looks like for me. It's still fairly busy and it's still fairly intense in terms of the number of hours of practice, but that's kind of what it looks like. I just came up with a little idea, practiced it for 3 or 4 hours. Now I get to share it with you. And now what I get to share with you for the rest of today's vlog is a little bit more of the footage from the gig with Bob Reynolds at the Baked Potato a few days ago with Teddy Campbell, Ty Bailey, and Dave DeLome. I think I'm gonna play a little bit of Feedback and a little bit of Closer, because they were both pretty burning versions of those tunes. And announcement, anyone in the Nashville area, we will be in Nashville Monday and Tuesday, August 7th and 8th, I believe those dates are. We will be in Nashville playing one night quartet with Bob Reynolds band, playing all Bob's music, with Sean Horton on drums, Nia Felder on guitar. And then the next night, this is all at Rudy's Jazz Room, by the way, new club in Nashville. I'll give more details as it goes, but just for the sake of getting the word out there and anyone around in Nashville, just wanted to let you guys know about it. And then the second night, the Tuesday night, we'll be doing a trio kind of co-led by me and Nia, a little bit of my music, a little bit of Nia's music. That'll be also with Sean Horton on drums. And yeah, two nights in Nashville. Really looking forward to that. Haven't been to Nashville in a minute. It's been over a year, so kind of really looking forward to that. It's gonna be a nice change of scenery, nice change of pace, not playing completely solo, and you know, playing with a band. It's always a lot of fun. So that's that. More information to come on that, of course, as we get closer. But yeah, today's vlog is done. Check out these next two cuts from the gig with Bob Reynolds. This is all from the GoPro audio, which I think is kind of good for just like shoving it up there on the clip. I did a whole vlog on the virtues of having a GoPro and how important that is for capturing concerts and capturing ideas and your practice routine and stuff. So this I hope should bolster that point, and I hope you dig it. This is Feedback and Closer from the Baked Potato a few days ago here in Los Angeles. Yeah.
Thank you.